Gang.
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 We are not part of a gang.
Gang.
We are not affiliated with any gangs.
Gang.
Unless you talk about ASAP Rocky.
We Jungle Beats.
And we are reviewing Testing. Whoo! For those who want... No!
Continue.
I'm Alexander Sandalis.
I'm the weapon of mass destruction itself, Excalibur.
For those of you who don't know, we review and react to music. We're based in Melbourne, Australia, and we'll get into Rocky's Testing. And for those who have wanted us to do the reviews a little quicker, enjoy this one, because it's going to be out ASAP Rocky.
Oh, boy! And before we get into it, I just want to state that ASAP Rocky has said that during the process of this album, a huge part of it being called Testing and also the dummy test on SoundCloud is because of why he just kept having to create, and scrap, and scrap, and scrap. The whole process of making this album was constantly just shifting through so many different sounds and unfamiliar territories for him within music. So we could get something that will be really different and I might not enjoy it, or maybe we'll get something that he can just pull off and it will just work. So
Can I give you an ASAP Rocky quote that gives some light on the album?
Yeah.
I think this one will be more deliberate. I'm experimenting in a more calculated way. I'm trying to make sure that I take precaution to where I'm not, and I'm not just drawing out of the lines or crazy mixing my colors. I'm still trying to give you a beautiful canvas, but something different. I want to take a different approach. I want to challenge the viewers tired of hearing the same old shit, you know? This shit is cliche at this point. I'm just trying to test my viewers, and if they're ready to evolve and grow with me, this is going to be an amazing fucking album, and I'm going to hopefully change a bunch of people's lives again, and hopefully people will make better music and influence me to make even better music.
Did you take a breath, man?
No.
Either way, I think that's beautiful, and I think that if you are going to stay as one of the great artists within our society, you have to keep changing. I mean, look at Kanye. He changed every album, in my opinion, so...
Let's go, man. Let's waste no more time.
Let's do it. ASAP Rocky.
Distorted Records.
Testing.
From the cellar to the basement, I don't feel a thing. Get the fuck up off my face, bitch, I don't feel a thing. Okay. See, I'm faded. Yeah, I'm shaking. I don't feel a thing. I just feel the bass. I can feel the bass. Distorted. Distorted Records. Another plane at Berkeley's. Cloud 9, hello, Earth things. My newest president of asshole. I guess that's why I'm leaving church things. My next used to chill with bad teams. All they talk about was bird things. Try to put them on the bad brains. Bird holes got the bird brains. Anything I do, ground break. Big body make the floor break. Please show the race. Please show the race. Please show the race.
What a dope fucking opener.
It's a nice intro, bro, with that distortion. Heavy.
I hate to be bringing it up again today, but it reminds me of Kanye Yeezus' On Site for a way to introduce the album.
Yeah, 100%.
Like, just sort of out of his comfort zone, yet still delivers. And Rocky was right. It still had his style with his raps, but really different production-wise. I love that fucking heavy fucking static sound when the bass comes in. That's a dope opener.
100%. No one really needs to be said. That's a great way to open an album.
It feels great.
Now, the next track is ASAP Forever, which we've heard, except it's with... T.I., Kid Cudi.
So I reckon that T.I. will be...
And Moby.
I reckon T.I. will be on the second verse, and I think Kid Cudi will do the finishing part where the beat switches. That's my prediction.
And we like this joint.
I like it.
We did. We reviewed it.
It's starting backwards, though. This is how it ends.
Okay.
It's T.I. right here.
Now you gotta be happy about your man Kid Cudi's verse. That was super smooth, bro. That fit it very well.
First up, It's better than the original?
100%.
I think
it's
also...
It's more refined.
I think that the intro from T.I. is very smart because...
Why?
Because you know how the start's always about like, gang. Gang, you know how there's a big build up to it?
And because, then he said R.I.P.
But because of the extra verse from Kid Cudi, there needs to be an extra hook. I think A$AP Rocky would have thought to himself, there's too much of me saying gang, there's too much build up, there needs to be less. So the intro from T.I. keeps it fresh, and he's also saying a lot to do with the A$AP group.
Interesting.
So T.I. is kind of like an ode to that, and also T.I. has a lot to do with the sounds, a lot of the sounds that A$AP Rocky was used in his early sort of music too. So it's kind of like they scrapped the intro, so he just comes fresh in with bars, fresh in with bars. Because the second track of the album is a lot of times, you know, the first track that's sort of... Because the first track of a lot of albums either be an intro or a really hard track, but like it's the first track where they're normally saying something on a lot of albums. I think it's a really smart move for him to come straight in after T.I. And a feature from Cudi. If you don't know, Kid Cudi's my favourite artist, and he sounded so smooth on there.
He did. Man, it's great to hear a little prelude to what we're going to get from him.
I really like... I just wanted to... Kid Cudi call him up and was like, I love this song, can I please come on it? Or did Rocky be like, I need Kid Cudi on this? And he had to wait for the verse to come
Who knows, man? It's really interesting. Oh. We'll see in the interviews, but...
I love it. That version's better.
It's even better.
You can... It improved an already amazing song with an amazing video.
Tony Tone.
It sounds like it's gonna be a banger. Is that Kid Cudi again?
I thought it was.
That's Kid Cudi. Oh. That fucking sounds like a violin going off and off.
Yeah, because Harlem, ASAP was
Harlem.
Derived from Harlem.
He's from Harlem. Yeah.
Yeah, man. Repping New York.
Another dope track. I love the instrumental. I like the off-kilter fiddle. It's like the...
That makes it super hypnotic.
Oh, I love it.
It makes the beat just ride.
And the drums were so beautiful. ASAP Rocky did this thing. I'm pretty sure he had all the verses. I'm kind of liking like the features from well-known artists throughout these albums. So, like Diddy was speaking, T.I. was speaking. I wonder if that has anything to do with the process of like... going through so many sounds and so many like eras of hip hop and being like, what do I want to go through? What do I want to discover musically that fits in well with my style already? Maybe that's kind of like what he's doing with these artists.
Like they're representing the different sonics.
Yeah, like maybe went through like a Bad Boy or like these sort of songs, these sort of artists. Can I take something from these artists and implement it with my music? Like,
it's an interesting hypothesis.
But that's another dope track. Very impressed so far.
Fuck Sleep. I'm not going to tell you the features. Keep it fresh.
I like that. Let's see if I can guess them.
Yeah. Oh shit! It's your boy Little Baby!
Fuck out of here.
Who's that?
That's FKA Twigs.
Holy shit, that was good.
It's FKA Twigs.
Oh, it took him 5 seconds.
Man, I love my girl.
When do we hear ASAP really flowing like that? I don't remember. If I do, it must have been a minute.
No, he's always had one of the best flows in hip hop. Ever since.
I'm not questioning his flow, I'm questioning the cadence of his flow right there. Da, 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 da,
no, I think he's always had that. Like, ever since his first tape that got pretty big, the main thing that people noticed was his flow and how different it was to hip hop and the way that it was just seamless. Of course, the production and being a pretty boy, like motherfucker like himself, helped, but like,
fuck,
that,
he's the handsome.
He's a pretty motherfucker. But yeah, I love that track. The beat is beautiful. I love the bass just outlining that whole track.
It's a subtle banger. Oh,
the hook is beautiful. The slight use of autotune that I think I picked up was lovely. FKA Twigs at the start.
Beautiful.
And her little bit of a bridge at the end.
Yeah.
Amazing. A really great track.
And I really like I said it before, I really like how an artist does that. Subtly puts a feature in there. Doesn't overstay or welcome.
Exactly. Right there. Perfect example. 4 for 4. Rocky, you're absolutely killing this album so far.
Praise the Lord! Sounds like he's merging his voice with someone else.
Well, pause. Oh wait, that's Skepta, sorry. I didn't even realize.
Deeper.
Alright. Is that it?
Just a tad too long. It's just 30 to 60 seconds too long. I mean, it's catchy. It's a catchy hook.
I think that's what it's meant to be, though. Like, him and Skepta using the flow like this, the whole track, it's because it's gone to be something that sounds kind of like, nah, I could just keep going, but...
It's also repetitive.
I think it's meant to be repetitive.
Yes, it is meant to be repetitive.
I think it's Rocky...
Is every track that's repetitive meant to be repetitive?
No. Fuck out of here. I'm sorry, I love you. I would never do anything. Yeah, I agree. I love the beat on this. The beat's so fun, so energetic. I think Skepta's feature on here suits the beat really well. I think if you just take it for what it is, it's just a really fun track where they're just trading really simple flows and just having fun. So I got nothing wrong with that track. I enjoyed it.
It's all right. Drop. How do I say that? Drop with the dollar sign at the end.
Kodak Black. Kodak Black? He has a really high pitched voice.
No feature.
I met this girl. She sucked my lollipop at the bus stop.
2 plus 2 is 4.
Stop. Right there.
Indeed. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
No, that track was a piece of shit. I didn't mind the production though. I didn't mind the synths.
No, I don't. No, I'm sorry. You have your opinion. Sorry, go ahead. No, man, the synths were fucking. They didn't work well with Rocky, man.
They didn't work well because of the voice alterations and the other things surrounding the synths.
Probably.
Like the lighter pattern drums and the other things surrounding it. I like the synths, but I feel like everything else surrounding around it, and also the other, if they were features, if it was all the voice alterations, it didn't work.
And drops. This track reminds me of how bad Bad Company was.
Like, I thought Bad Company was better than this. Bad Company beat was fucking hard. Hard as fuck.
What about that interlude? I think that interlude was pretty lazy too.
I thought the interlude would have been good if the track that followed it sort of followed it up in a way which made the interlude good. You know what I mean? Like sometimes the track after an interlude makes the interlude great. But that's...
Let's get to the next track.
I guess that's why this album's called Testing, because not everything is going to work.
Right, fair enough. Go on. Background. Yeah.
I fuck with that. I think it's a really good track. The production was absolutely amazing on there. I'm pretty sure that's a sample of 36 Mafia, hence why Juicy J's ad lib came up on there. Just the way that, if you listen to this track really carefully, the way that this track progresses, like the production starts off with that sort of silly sort of sound to it, and then it switches up towards the sample. And then towards the very end of the track, each of the different implements of the track that we've already heard keep overlapping each other and taking, like, it just keeps changing towards the last minute of the song. I think it's like an absolutely amazingly produced track, and I think ASAP Rocky flows really nice over it. It's a dope track.
His flow is definitely a highlight.
That's so good.
I mean, I need to give it some more listens, but I didn't particularly enjoy it that much.
Oh, man, you enjoy it. I personally loved it. Thought that was a really good track. I fuck with it. After the last track especially. That last track was fucking horseshit.
Brother man.
Like you, drip Raheem and Q, got high C like you. I'm a hobby guy like he got three strikes too. Real niggas be like me, like you.
Hey.
That's why I got a beam with a green light too. I don't even make a scene, I just swing right through. I'm looking at God's view from towers, looking down like I'm Donald Trump.
What, like I'm Donald Trump?
Did he say something about the two towers and looking down like he's Trump?
I didn't hear two towers.
No, I didn't hear. Oh well.
The rhyme scheme towards the middle was super dope, but I don't know if that really matched the production. I don't know. The production's like, it's real interesting. Like, I don't know if I'm feeling it. I'm gonna need some more listens, man. It's different to me.
I really like that track as well. I love the production. The soulful female sample in the background over that's really nice. I like his use of autotune because a lot of his autotune usage has been pretty bad. I feel like here it was like the right amount and it wasn't over executed. It was done quite well. I love the soulful piano. I love the violin I heard a bit of, and there was another instrument in the back there. Instrumentation was lovely. I like the switch up, like I said, to the middle verse where he started rapping really good. The beat switched up a bit to that. This is definitely an example of him
testing
and it working, in my opinion. The last two tracks, especially this track here, is Rocky going into unknown territories, and I believe doing it in a way which really works.
And I don't know. I don't know. I'm undecided yet. I don't know if it's working yet for me.
I think exactly what he said in the thing he stated beforehand is exactly what this is. He's implementing other styles with his own style and hopefully making it work. And I think that track we heard that we didn't like with those synths is a good example of it not working. And here is a perfect example of it working to us as listeners.
OG Beeper. Older sister, baby, we're the go to rapper. Yeah. She said, quiet down, but you know the most of the time. Okay. I don't know why I do. Oh. Hey. 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 Alright. I'm sent to boot back, just miss me out the beat, but OG beat is different. Close it on the corner like a trapper. Why you moving hands all around like a rapper? Why you turn niggas fucking other niggas?
That was fucking dope.
Would you call that production zany? Is it, to use your word, weird? I think it's kind of weird and I like it.
I'd say sort of maybe a little robotic or industrial in a way. Has that little slightness to it. Either way, I love the switch up from like
the switch up in the middle
to the
that kept it fresh, man, and dynamic.
It was sick, and especially when he took the beat away so many times and came back in like bah, and then the beat would come back in. He did that a lot of times.
It was a strong track.
Really strong track. Definitely a bit of a trap influence through there as well. I fuck with it.
Production's nice, man.
Fun track. Really fucking nice. Good production.
Kids turned out fine.
Yeah.
swear to God, ladies and gentlemen in the guy. The doctor called me, the black dude hopped in my shoe car. See him broke, I'm watching crawl.
Again, we're getting a different vibe, man. That electric guitar carrying that track right there. And once again, I'm indifferent. I don't know if that works for him. But try some new shit, man. Whatever.
I'm quite fond of the production. I like the light use of the guitar. And then it's a really smooth sort of beat. Like the...
It's smooth, I guess.
It kind of has very like sort of happy vibes. I like the way how he sort of like distorts it a bit. Like it's an old record. Like an old record failing. He does it a few times.
But that vibe doesn't feel like it's like... It hasn't, that vibe hasn't come out throughout any of the albums so far.
No, but once again, this is testing. So I feel like maybe after this album, as much as he wants to grow, he'll probably feed off the feedback of his fans and be like, what did they like the most from this album? What is the...
You think he's that humble to really listen to him?
Yeah, I think so. Because I think he's at a stage of his career where he's not sure what he wants to do, hence this album. Like he wants to explore these new territories. I think that he would actually love to know what majority of his fans like more. And maybe he'll be like, you know what, I actually do like doing this sound. And if they really like the sound, maybe I'll do an album concept based off this sound. So maybe he'll go for that direction.
We shall see.
I don't love this track, but I do like a lot of the production on here. I think that his hook kind of does suit it in a way, because it is quite a smooth melody like the beat. But I think that his raps on there didn't suit it that much. I think the raps is what really didn't really do well on here. But it's still an okay track. It could grow on me, but I'm not hating it. It's all right.
Hazy track right there. Didn't really engage me at all.
I feel like
don't
he was
really
trying to do
for it. No!
I feel like he was trying to do too much on that track. Because I thought that the production on that track was really beautiful. Like
you have so many words, Alexander, in your heart.
What?
Alexander, you have so many words. Let them out, my friend. Let them out.
Thank you for your permission, good sir. But no, the production that was beautiful. Like the light synths, like the slow drums. It kind of had that chopped and screwed sort of sound to it. Like their southern sort of sound. But yeah, just the use of his vocals, I thought were like you said, very lazy, hazy. And I felt like I would have liked more bars from him on this song. I thought that the beat could have complemented some nice flows from Rocky, but he kind of was a bit too lazy on here. And then a lot of the sounds and samples put in there, it felt like he was trying to do too much with this track when this track really just needed to be a bit more minimal.
Much more simpler would have benefited it.
But I still really like the production. Definitely the highlight of the track. Really, really well produced. Whoever's been producing a lot of this album has done an amazing job.
Changes.
Dun, dun, dun.
You like the production so far on this album?
Yes, but I've been writing down notes for the conclusion.
Oh, you have? Nice. Just give me something, man.
There you go.
He's slowing down the album, it seems like.
Probably just sick of making hype shit.
Maybe. I don't know how you can get sick of that. Still a young guy.
Eat every girl after replying. Best of luck to you. Fast forward a couple months, I'm like, what's up with you? Cause something changed, I know you feel it. But really, it's been a little minute. Ain't nothing changed but the address. My name is.
It's like everything that changed that could be good just instantly became bad. It's like, oh shit, oh shit. Oh shit, oh
shit. Shitting on me, my little box. My biggest distractions is that I get distracted.
Same track?
People suing me for shit that didn't happen. I wonder how the world would be if they didn't have me.
This is about 10 tracks. Before it switches up another 10 times, I just want to say this track doesn't know what it wants to be. It wants to be a guy, a girl. You know, it's a bit like Bruce Jenner. This track's a bit like the Jenners. Or is that...
Yeah, hold up. What's this beat change?
Oh, it's getting me. Oh, it's the best track ever. Oh.
I actually have a lot to say in it.
That ending, though. This track didn't know what it wanted to be, bro. It didn't know what it wanted to be. A butterfly or a caterpillar.
I disagree. I think this track's really beautiful. I think that the track's called Changes.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, the beats change all the time. But if you notice, the beat always changes when the chick that he's talking about the song, it's a different time. Because the start of the track, when he's talking, changes. It switches and it goes to, yo, this chick, she sent me a message saying, you know, I don't want to do this anymore. And he's just like, oh, good luck. And then he goes, and I just went around fucking other girls. And then when the beat switches up again, he goes back to, I hit this girl up again. And then it basically gets to the very end with the last beat, which is where it's just like the chick has you know, got kids and stuff. And it's just like, it's about that. So if you actually really pay attention, each beat switch is a different time that he's talking to this girl. So it represents a different time.
I mean, if that's, he did that on purpose, that's
definitely,
that's,
man,
a nice little touch.
That's 100% what he did.
Well, we don't know that. Could just be coincidental.
I don't think so. Listening, I really pay attention to that one. I feel like the track's called Changes. The beat switch represents the change. It represents the time that he's talking to this girl. And obviously, it just goes to show, like, I think Rocky's contemplating, like, each of those times. He, like, each time he talked to this chick, he had a chance to possibly have a life with this girl. And he gets to the stage where it's just like, it's too late. And that's when the track ends. And it just goes about, just talking about life and its changes. I think this is definitely one of the best tracks in the album, in my opinion.
Okay.
At first, I was like, the second beat switch, I was like, I don't really like that one it's doing, but the further this track progressed, the more I saw the
mastery. You saw the picture.
I saw the picture. I saw the mastery and the art behind it. Okay. I think this is definitely a really good track.
Okay, cool. Like, nearly done.
See, I like when we have, like, big differences like that. Oh, I do too.
That's important, bro, because it doesn't happen that often.
It doesn't. No, we're just like, that shit was fire! That shit was trash! That shit was great!
Anyway, yeah. All the other way.
Yo, that shit trash. Yo, what was that? Say the fucking words!
I like that little robotic thing. Cool.
I wasn't huge on that track.
No, next track.
You want to talk about a little bit?
I have nothing to talk about in this one.
I don't know. I still like the production.
Educate me. Enlighten me.
Enlighten you?
Enlighten me.
I don't know. I just feel like the way that he used his voice in that track was quite, once again, quite in a lazy way, I guess. Yeah. I know he's trying different shit all the time, but
it's not very engaging to me when he does that.
Yeah, but once again, the production was very well crafted. I dug a lot of it. Pretty much nearly, probably about all the tracks that I don't like on this album from Rocky's voice perspective, I still enjoy the production. There has not been a track on this album where I thought the beat is whack. The beats have always been on point. So that's the one thing I'm going to give this album so far.
I'm going to pause what I want to say. I'm going to leave what I'm about to say to the end.
All right,
about the production. Last track. Purity.
Oh my God. Do you realize we get the last track without me saying, are we at the last track yet?
That's a good sign.
It's a good sign.
Purity featuring
Danny Brown.
I've been busy.
Nah.
I've been fucking busy.
Is that Ferg?
I've been busy fucking.
Kendrick Lamar. You won't guess it.
Woof woof dogs in a place, loose tooth, lost in a fray, roof lost on a brake, roof lost on a weight, freeway, no rose, roof force, roof champagne, tell the front desk, good new keys, thought on a slug, sold on slug, team, chewing on nothing, tweaking or something, reaching for something, your speakers pick up and you're thinking, you're overthinking, one blinking, a pre coming, I could turn every no one into someone.
That was Rocky. Was it?
Google Maps
and
your iMac, think my phone tap, hold up, hold that. Nigga pulled up, so the nigga hold that call, tryna hold back the call, hat drop when the FaceTime calls. Don't call back, can't cope when your heart broke. So lost nothing since Timberland, seen us at 10-16.
I'm undone because
I live someone every release. Feel like a curse is in me, except Percy is gone in a grief.
Frank had the first verse?
The Frank had the first verse. That was really? Frank, bro.
Because I knew, the only reason I knew it was Frank is that afterwards when he used his auto-tune, like the da-da-da, because he used that in Blonde. That's how I knew it was Frank, but I didn't notice that was him on the verse.
The first, that was, Frank's verse was incredible. One, that was my favorite track. Two, when they did the hook and that ending, that was Frank Ocean and Lauryn Hill.
Oh, shit. Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's beautiful.
It is beautiful. That's my favorite track. One of my favorite tracks probably right there. Probably the favorite one. Beautiful way to end it.
Yeah, I really enjoyed the light guitar. I wasn't really listening to too much what Rocky was saying, but neither. I feel like he was definitely saying a lot in that track. Frank was amazing. A really good closer.
Frank, Lauryn Hill, ASAP Rocky. What a trio.
And that brings us to testing.
Can I close out my thoughts first?
100%.
All right, because I know you'll have a lot to say on this.
100%?
And I won't have... And I won't have much to say. To close it out, testing to me, it's obviously a testament. He's testing a lot of different sounds and sonics. This album is not cohesive. It's not meant to be. Fine.
He's testing his sexuality.
He's testing a lot of things, and that's cool. I like that. For me, a lot of the testing didn't vibe with me. It didn't really work. I want to talk to you, man, like our radio day. Let's talk, baby.
Let's get. Come let's on, talk. Let's get
do you remember how like we used to talk to each other?
Yo.
Back in the radio. All right. Yeah.
But can you remember what tracks that you didn't like and what you'd do differently?
The last half of the album particularly I didn't enjoy as much, didn't resonate with me as much. On the production side, from the middle to the last to the end of it, just got a bit softer, and the production didn't resonate with me. I thought it was too much.
And if you notice, like in the first four tracks, we were really hyped and really enjoying it. But then there was that fifth track with Skepta, which sort of stagnated a little bit, and then that interlude, and from then on to track six.
No, you're right. Yeah.
So 1/3 into the album is where you start to stagnate.
That's a very good point. Obviously, I have a particular type of sound I like to hear Rocky on, and Rocky, I don't love him as an artist. I like him, so that's probably another reason too. But to me, this album is okay. Right now, and yeah, man, a lot of the stuff that resonated with you didn't particularly resonate with me. And this is something we don't often happen to us.
I think this album's definitely one that grows on you, because I feel like a lot of what he's trying to do in this album does work, but it takes a lot of listeners for you to understand it, because you're not very used to Rocky with these sounds.
No,
because obviously with like Rocky's first tape, like when you first listen, you're like, oh fuck, who's this? Like, who's this Clams Casinos? What's these bars like? And the more you listen, the more you get it. Here, Rocky's doing so much new stuff that you just can't really understand it, because you just got to really give it some more thought. I wrote a few things down.
Please share them.
So my opinion with this album is the weakness of this album. To me, this is a good album on a first listen. There's a lot I love from it, but there's a lot I don't. The weakness of this album is it tries to do way too much.
It is, but isn't it kind of meant to do too much?
Well, that's the point, yeah.
And that's the problem as well. It's just cursing its gift.
It's cursing its gift. I honestly think that something like this should be done as a mixtape. But obviously with how good the production was in this album, then it can't be. Like my favorite thing about this album is the production. I think that every single track in this album was really well executed production-wise. There is not a bad thing wrong with the production of this album. It's just Rocky's vocals.
It's so interesting because I could feel like quite different. And I want to hear you guys too. How do you vibe with this production? Let me know. Let us know. We want to know.
I feel like Rocky's vocals is the weakness of this album, because I'd hear the production be, oh yeah, I fuck with this. It's so different to the last track, but what's he going to do with it? And that's the thing about this album is testing, is like, sometimes his vocals work really well, like the last track or one of the other tracks talked about, but sometimes they just fall short, either be it the autotune or the tempo or his flow. Like, it just, you know, we're supposed to hear in that same flow Rocky with the doing his thing, but here he just does so much. I honestly think that after this album, he should focus on one of the sounds. Yep. Like, one of the sounds that work for him, do a whole 10-track album based
super
off that.
Super cohesive.
Because I'm not a big fan of albums like this where there's so many sounds going on that it's like it's so hard to make sense of it. I much prefer an album where, be it like we heard with Pusha T before, seven tracks from the same producer, near amazing.
That's why it's so hard for me as well, because we just listened to Pusha T's Daytona,
which was absolutely amazing
and super cohesive, and then we get something so starkly different sonically. Mm.
So I really hope that like I said, I know the production was amazing, but I really feel like he should have gone for a mixtape route with this, like done a mixtape, and then from that mixtape worked on an album on one of the sounds that worked really well on that mixtape. But he's obviously like gone for doing it this way, and hey, maybe it'll work really well for him, because I do think that a lot of this album was amazing.
I'm curious to see what the fans think, you know, it'll be real interesting.
I don't have the track list up right now, but I feel like A lot of the tracks in this album, I started off being like, this isn't going to work. And then towards the end, I was just like, oh shit, I get this. Oh shit, I understand this.
I saw that.
Like the 3-6 Mafia sample one, the one with all the beat changes, like, but there's still a lot to be desired. Like, I can see myself going back to this album and listening to it, but like, it's just, there's just so much going on. I'm pretty happy with this. I don't mind waiting. I think it's been 4 years since Rocky dropped an album.
A long time, bro.
4 or 5 years maybe, but either way, I'm happy with this project, and I just really hope that this is the sort of thing that his fans can grow with, and that Rocky, I really hope Rocky's next project, he focuses on his sound and goes with it instead of doing something like this again, because I think that every artist in their life can do one of these albums.
Yes, agreed. We've talked about this before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's all I gotta say.
Let's wrap it up, man.
Yeah, I enjoyed it. I didn't love it. I'm gonna go back to it, and maybe I'll fall in love with it more. I enjoy a lot of the experimentation. Production is the best part of this album. Rocky needs to definitely work on a lot of his vocals.
As Dad, you heard it first, man. Jungle Beats. Let us know what you thought. We want to hear them below. Make sure to subscribe. Like our Facebook and Instagram, because we're trying to grow that, you know? It's where you put our shit up too, if you want to stay tuned.
Exactly, y'all. Thank you very much for tuning in, and we'll catch you around next time. We're motherfucking Jungle Beats.
This guy's plugged to the cringest cringe in the cringe.
A rebel I'll be one day. On that track with gunplay. Outcast my whole life, so I decide to spit like Andre. Beef is on my entree. Gin and juice, that's Bombay. Driving fast the wrong way, I swear life is like a one way. Pussy on a Sunday.